how to get the best video quality on your YouTube videos. Now in today's video, I will show you what the best bitrate is when you're rendering your YouTube videos in 1080p, 1440p or 4K in order to get the best possible image quality on YouTube. But before jumping right into the results of today's video, I would like to mention that if you're interested in these kinds of videos, then you should definitely consider subscribing and hitting that bell icon such that you won't miss any of my future uploads. Currently, only a measly 2.8% of people watching my content are currently subscribed to this channel. In fact, if only 5% of people that watched my channel over the last 90 days decided to actually subscribe to my channel, I would have already doubled my subscriber count by today. So if you're interested in these very in-depth and scientific videos on the YouTube algorithm, streaming or gaming, then I would highly appreciate it if you could support my work by subscribing to the channel. Now, before getting into the results of this video, I would like to mention that I am well aware that YouTube does have a page up with the recommended bit rates. Naturally, what YouTube recommends is much lower than what you actually should go for if you want the highest possible visual quality on your YouTube videos. This frankly isn't surprising at all, because YouTube has to store each and every file that is uploaded to the platform in its original form, and therefore wants people to upload lower file sizes in order to keep up with the storage requirement of the huge amount of people uploading videos to YouTube. And with having said that, let's jump right into a too long didn't watch segment where I'm gonna explain what the best possible bitrate is to get the highest possible video quality on YouTube. Now, from my testing, I found that simply increasing the bitrate ever higher would always lead to a higher quality of the final YouTube video. Therefore, the kind of very uninteresting and anticlimactic result of this test was that the highest possible bitrate that you can render at, or that you can still upload the video at to YouTube, would result in the highest possible video quality on YouTube. Obviously, this isn't exactly a satisfying result, as not everybody's going to be able to upload humongous file sizes to YouTube, or simply because they don't have enough space on their local machine to store all their huge YouTube projects. So because of that, I also tried to figure out what the optimal bitrate is, after which point you're not really seeing much of a visual improvement of the final product on YouTube. So at the resolution of 1080p, I would recommend a bitrate of 40 megabits per second or 40,000 kilobits per second. At 1440p, I would recommend 60 megabits per second or 60,000 kilobits per second. And finally, at 4K, I would recommend between 80 and 100 megabits per second or 80,000 to 100,000 kilobits per second. Right, so those would be my recommended target bit rates for your YouTube videos. Next, let me also explain how I derived these numbers for the best possible visual quality on YouTube. Now, what I did was I went into a game of Counter-Strike Global Offensive, and I recorded a 5-minute segment in this game. I then imported this clip into DaVinci Resolve and rendered it at various different target bit rates. Next, I uploaded the render clips to YouTube, let it process, and then re-downloaded the finally processed versions from YouTube. This downloaded version I then compared to the original recorded clip using the Perceptual Video Quality Assessment VMAF, which was introduced for Netflix, in order to figure out exactly what the quality of the finally encoded video on YouTube is. This entire process I then repeated for Call of Duty Modern Warfare Warzone to get two different data points for the same resolution and bitrates. These clips are recorded using NVIDIA ShadowPlay at 1440p and a bitrate of 130 megabits per second. Now, the reason why I went for CSGO as well as Warzone as kind of my games to do these tests with was that CSGO has rather simple graphics. I mean, even at the highest graphical presets, which I used for this experiment, the graphics are more or less very easy to encode. Whereas on the other hand, Warzone, also at the highest possible graphical settings, has much more foliage and is much more difficult to encode for YouTube's encoder. For that reason, you'll also see that all of the Warzone results are much lower in terms of their quality assessment when compared to CSGO at the same bitrate. And with that, it's time to dive into the results of my investigation. Starting off with 1080p, I would like to show how the perceived visual quality of the final YouTube video depends on the target bitrate that was used to render the video with. So what we're trying to look for here is to get the highest possible VMAF, or kind of perceptual visual quality of the YouTube video, while maintaining an as low as possible bitrate. Now on this graph, you can see two lines. The red one is for CSGO, whereas the blue one is for Warzone. As previously mentioned, CSGO is much easier to encode for YouTube, and therefore the overall quality assessment results in much higher numbers compared to Warzone. As expected, when going from 10 megabits to 20 megabits per second, the visual quality steeply increases, so the resulting video on YouTube actually looks much better when uploading at 20 megabits compared to 10 megabits. The same is true when increasing to 30 megabits per second and again to 40 megabits per second. Thereafter, you can see that the line kind of stagnates and doesn't significantly increase with increasing the bitrate any further, which kind of represents this sweet spot bitrate that we were talking about earlier. Now, we could extend this line even further to the right. I did test at 70 and 80 megabits per second for Warzone. However, the quality really doesn't significantly improve after this point. On the other hand, I never saw that the visual quality ever decreased when increasing the bitrate even further. So realistically, the only real limit here is your upload speed and the space on your PC. However, honestly, I wouldn't recommend to go beyond 40 megabits per second at 1080p, since the improvement in visual quality really isn't worth when going to even higher bitrates. Next, let's hop into my results at 1440p. Again, Counter-Strike Global Offensive has a much higher visual quality at the same bitrate than Warzone. However, the overall shape is somewhat similar when comparing those two games. Now, while we did see a very nice kind of asymptote at about 40 megabits per second at 1080p for both Warzone and CSGO, this really isn't as apparent at 1440p. Now, the line kind of flattens out more so for CSGO than Warzone, but both still kind of increase significantly when going to even higher bit rates. So at 1440p, it appears that if you want to get the highest possible visual quality on YouTube, then you could go to even something like 130 megabits per second on your video renders to get the highest possible quality. However, a more conservative number probably is about 60 megabits per second, after which point the increase in visual quality really isn't gonna be as worth it, especially for uploading CSGO over the longer render times and longer upload times. Now finally, at 4K, you can see that the results are very comparable to 1440p. The improvement in visual quality when uploading CSGO isn't as great as when uploading Warzone, and it also kind of starts to stagnate at about 80 to 100 megabits per second. On the other hand, uploading Warzone content apparently always benefits from a higher target bitrate and therefore also results in a higher VMAF score. Therefore, my recommendation at 4K would be to render between 80 and 100 megabits per second. Now, something else that I'd like to mention here is that if you're using CRF values instead of a target bitrate in your video editing software, then you can simply select a CRF value that kind of results in a bitrate, which is somewhat close to what I recommend in this video. From my quick testing, I found that a CRF of 18 resulted in 105 megabits per second at 1440p, so you probably want to drop that to around 20 or 21 to get the 60 megabits per second that I recommend in this video. Now, besides looking at these VMAF scores, it's also quite interesting to look at the overall bitrate and file size of the encoded video on YouTube. Now, at 1080p, we can see that the final file size and the encoded bitrate of the 1080p version on YouTube doesn't significantly increase when increasing the target bitrate of the rendered original video. On the other hand, what is actually really exciting to see is the fact that YouTube increases the bitrate at 1440p when you increase the bitrate of your original rendered video. With that, the overall file size also significantly increases comparing a 10 megabit to a 90 megabit rendered 1440p video, which also explains the increase in visual fidelity of the originally 90 megabit version. Now, while this holds true for both games that I tested here, this is much more apparent for Warzone, which is much more difficult for YouTube to encode. Finally, the bitrate that YouTube assigns a 4K video to does not significantly increase when increasing the bitrate of the original video. Now, something else that's interesting to look at here is that with 1440p, you're obviously also getting a 1080p version on YouTube. Now, I also downloaded these lower resolution re-encodes from YouTube to try and see how they compare to uploading the video in 1080p instead. As you can see, the visual quality of the 1440p version played back at 1080p is actually much higher than when originally uploading in 1080p. As you can see, even at the same exact target bitrate, a video that is rendered in 1440p always produces a nicer looking 1080p version than when uploading the video in 1080p instead. Now, the reason for this difference is that obviously the 1080p version of my videos only triggered AVC or were only encoded in AVC codec, whereas on the other hand, the 1440p version was always re-encoded in VP9. Therefore, the 1080p encode of the originally 1440p video is also available in VP9, resulting in lower file size but better visual quality. So basically, if you're recording in 1080p and you want the best possible visual quality at 1080p, then you should definitely upscale your footage to 1440p and then get the VP9 codec, which will result in the much better visual quality on your YouTube videos. Finally, let's also have a look at the re-encoded versions of the 4K video on YouTube, so at the 1440p encode and the 1080p encode of the originally 4K video. As you can see in this case, the re-encoded 1440p version is of worse quality than when uploading the video in 1440p instead. The reason for that is that obviously the raw recorded clip that I had for this test was recorded in 1440p, and therefore upscaling it to 4K introduced some visual artifacts in terms of the filtering that has been used to upscale the video, and therefore taking that version which was upscaled and then downscaled again obviously results in the lower overall video quality than when uploading the video in 1440p directly. On the other hand, the 1080p encode of the 4K version is still a much higher visual quality than when uploading the video in 1080p directly. Now, all of the results of today's video are available publicly in a Google spreadsheet that you can access via the link in the description below. But with that, I think it's time to wrap up today's video. So as I said, I would recommend about 40 megabits per second at 1080p, about 60 megabits per second at 1440p, and finally 80 to 100 megabits at 4K. Now obviously, if you're uploading content that isn't as heavy as gameplay footage, for example, recordings of your desktop, then really you don't actually have to go as high as I recommend in this video. Obviously, this test has been performed on gameplay footage, and therefore those values are rather on the high end of what you should probably select for the best possible visual quality on YouTube. Now, if you guys want me to test any other games, then definitely tell me so in the comments down below, and make sure to check out the spreadsheet on which all of the results shown in this video are based on. But that is it for today, guys. I hope this video was helpful. It has definitely taken me a long while to actually produce the results for this video, so I really hope you guys enjoyed it. If you did, leave a like and subscribe for more content like this. Thank you guys so much for watching, have a wonderful day, and I'll see you guys in the next video.